for joining us on a very special Thursday night. Welcome to the MPX Event Center. Welcome to Metroplex Wrestling. And welcome to Shock and Awesome! In this ring, you will see four women competing for the honor to be the number one contender and face Hilda for the MPX Women's Championship. And we're going to start off that action right now.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a very special Thursday edition of MPX as we bring you Shock and Awesome. My name is Cody Cox. Normally, I am joined here at ringside by Tyler Foster. Tyler is not here tonight.
Shock and Awesome is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Columbia, Missouri, 2,000 pounds of heavy metal, the Heavy Metal Maiden, Morgan Mercy!
As I was saying, Tyler is not here tonight. I will be joined on commentary momentarily by Matt Andrews. As you guys saw at the end of last week, the Shiesty Mob, the group that has been attacking people left and right, they laid out everyone, including myself, including Matt, including Tyler. I spoke to Tyler earlier today. He is doing fine. He is not showing up here tonight out of protest as he does not feel safe. I cannot say that I blame him. Maybe the only time I'll ever agree with Tyler Foster. But we do hope to have Tyler here real soon. But as we heard Matt Andrews say to kick us off, we've got a number one contenders tournament tonight. Four participants, the winner of the tournament this evening, will go on next week to face Hilda for the MPX Women's title. And right now we're kicking off Morgan Mercy and Maya World.
And her opponent from Dallas, Texas, the It Girl, Maya World.
Huge opportunity tonight for Maya World, Morgan Mercy, and then our other semifinal tournament match, which we will see in a little bit. Erica Torres and Shay Carmichael, the winner of these two matches, will face each other later on in the finals. And again, the winner going on to face Hilda next week for the MPX Women's Championship. Being joined right now by our very own Matt Andrews. Matt, welcome to commentary.
Hey, I appreciate it. I do want to say that this marks me having held every job here at Metroplex Wrestling.
Well, enough. And you can thank Tyler Foster for that. I mentioned Tyler. He's doing fine, not showing up here tonight. He did not feel safe to be here with the Shiesty Mob in attendance. And we are, whether we like it or not, going to see and hear from the Shiesty Mob later on. Tata Manning has said he is calling out the Shiesty Mob after their actions last week. We also know MPX Championship will be on the line. The champion, Demo Diamond, one-on-one with a former MPX champion, the final boss, Exodus Prime. But right now, Maya World, obviously with a huge height disadvantage.
Yeah, you know, I'd really be curious to hear who you think the underdog here in this match is. I mean, Morgan Mercy, obviously, with the height and the weight advantage, but Maya World has a wealth of experience and has been traveling so far, so short of the time.
Look, I think height and power go a long way, and I think that does give Morgan Mercy the advantage here. And look at this power from Maya World.
Speaking of.
Yeah, tried to counter with that arm drag, but it's going to take a lot more than that.
I mean, Morgan weighs 2,000 pounds of heavy metal. So very clearly, that's going to be an issue.
Oh, huge forearm shot. I have to believe the MPX Women's Champion, Hilda, is somewhere watching on, waiting to see her opponent will be next week. As Maya World gets that boot up. And now on the shoulders of Morgan. Oh, nicely done. Look at this.
Fantastic maneuver. I used to use a move like that, a figure four headlock around the ropes. But obviously, being caught in the ropes, kind of a little bit of a problem for Maya World.
Maya World impressing the addicts here tonight. And she got caught.
There's that height and weight advantage again.
And that's going to come into play a lot here for Morgan Mercy. Just sending Maya World abdomen first across the knee.
You mentioned Hilda watching somewhere. Hilda hasn't defended her championship in quite some time. And you got to wonder what the rest is going to do. So hopefully she's studying up on these opponents. Because when she faces them next week, she's going to need all the resources that she can get.
I think that's a great point. And it should be a very rested Hilda. We have not seen Hilda since the purge. As Morgan Mercy in full control right now. And appreciate all the addicts joining us here tonight, twitch.tv/Metroplex Wrestling. A very special Thursday edition of MPX.
It's kind of nice having people in here on Thursday. I feel like it's a more intimate show. And, you know, the MPX strides itself on being kind of a family environment. So this is kind of like performing for our family here.
Oh, and Maya misses with a kick. And now look at Morgan.
Oh,
huge Saito suplex dropping Maya World right on the back of her head.
Absolutely. No amount of striking that Maya World was going to do to Morgan Mercy was going to counter that.
No cover. Nope. We're seeing a very aggressive side of Morgan Mercy here tonight.
Absolutely. Well, I mean, she's the heavy metal maiden. I mean, that proves itself to be a very aggressive misnomer.
Well, and not only that, she knows, Matt, what this MPX Women's Championship is all about. There's only been two champions in the history of the title since it was introduced at the beginning of this year, Erica Torres, who we're going to see later on, and of course the title currently held by Hilda. Morgan Mercy would love to add her name to that list, but she's got to get past a couple of opponents here tonight.
Yeah, she does, and it's all happening in one night too, and I think that needs to be pointed out, that the quicker that Morgan Mercy, or Maya Wolf for that matter, can end this match, the better, to give themselves more of a rest opportunity to face their other opponent later in the night.
Absolutely, that's a great point, as we see Morgan right now keeping Maya World grounded. Almost a variation of a cross-faced chicken wing.
Almost, but she's got to lock those hands, Cody. She doesn't have that, and that's what happens. She gave Maya the opportunity to break free and hit her with that jawbreaker.
And now Maya charges in, and Morgan, again with the power, has her up on the shoulders. Could be looking for the face melter. No, Maya has it scouted down the back. And now Morgan charging in.
And there you go, Maya World doing her homework.
Well, and maybe trying to wear Morgan Mercy down a little bit. Playing a little bit of a cat and mouse game with her. Oh, what a super kick.
A lot of repeated shots to that jaw.
And now Maya springboard, face first, goes Mercy. This is buying Maya World some time.
It's a great complete shot, springboard variation of it. And again, that had to have been the fourth or fifth shot that Morgan's taken directly to the face and on the jaw. She's got to be disoriented right now.
And Maya with a nice kip up. And out from the middle rope, crossbody, taking Mercy off her feet.
That was right there next to the guardrail. Really lucky that nobody got a concussion from that.
Right there in front of our MPX addicts here in attendance tonight. Mercy sent back in. And Maya has to be able to smell victory right now.
Another kick straight to the head.
Face first again goes Mercy. Maya with the cover. Is she going to move on to the finals? No. Mercy getting that left shoulder up.
Not a bad attempt at a pinfall. Great time to do it right there, but it's obviously going to take a lot more to put down the heavy metal maiden.
And now Mercy being brought back to her knees, and Maya went for another super kick. Mercy caught it.
Taking a little too much time.
Oh, didn't catch that one. Mercy caught that one right on the chin.
I'm surprised Morgan doesn't have a dislocated jaw. Oh, and another one right to the head.
Her and Karana sending Mercy face first in the mat, too. No, that was close.
That was probably the closest pinfall in this match. Closest pinfall we've seen.
Mercy getting that right shoulder up. And again, the winner of this match will face the winner of Torres and Carmichael.
That's happening next, I believe.
Absolutely, as now Maya World might be looking to go up top, but she can't take too much time here with Mercy.
And I think you're seeing that right now, Cody.
And Mercy back to her feet.
Oh, very precarious position. This can't be good for Maya World.
And Mercy looking for that powerbomb out of the corner. Maya with the counter. There's the Rana.
Real surprise she got her over, honestly. But Morgan's been worn down so much.
Oh, springboards right into a headbutt. That's and crazy. Mercy not letting her go down. We're going to see it. Face melter on Maya World. Mercy with the cover. And Mercy's going to advance.
Here is your winner.
Morgan Mercy is now just one victory away from facing Hilda here next week for that women's championship.
But Cody, I gotta tell you, she took so many shots to the head. Even the final blow was a headbutt into the face melter. You've gotta wonder how disoriented Morgan might be going into that match later on.
Morgan Mercy hoping to go to the back and get plenty of rest and get as close to 100% as possible ahead of the finals. As she will take on the winner, it'll either be Erica Torres or Shea Carmichael later on tonight.
Not gonna lie, she actually looks like she's doing just fine.
Hey, yo! And as we continue with Shock and Austin, it looks like before we get our next semifinal match in the women's tournament, we are going to hear from the MPX champion and Jamie Oller.
MPX,
shut up! People, do you understand me?
Well, I've been cut off by far worse and in far worse ways.
What I'm not gonna do is sit here and listen to any more unfounded rumors.
Do you think he had some earwax surgery? What happened up there?
The unofficial photographer, Brian Pulver. Yeah, I'm looking at you, you piece of garbage. Yeah, you want it? Shut it right there, right there. I'm sorry I didn't have enough time for you idiots to point out that my eyes are not looking at the shiesty mob. They are looking at all of you. All of you pathetic losers who cheer and believe in Tatum Manning. You're going to believe a picture from a guy who thought it was a good idea to jump in a moving truck. And he ate more concrete than Tatum Manning ate chair last week. The fact is, I have not now or ever been associated with the shiesty mob. Shut up! As a matter of fact,
I don't think the addicts believe him, Cody.
I'd say shut your mouth, but don't think you understand that concept.
You don't understand.
Here's the deal. I have more money than all of you people put together, which means I will hire an attorney to sue and shut your mouth. You look like the kind of guy that would climb the roof of a sloped building, if you know what I mean. All right, so you might want to sit there and keep your mouth shut.
Wow.
I don't get it.
For the last time, I am not behind the shiesty mob attacks. I don't know who the... Shut up!
Hurry up!
Who said hurry up? I will literally sit here all damn night because I don't care. It's a Thursday. I'll keep all those stupid kids up. They won't be able to go to school tomorrow.
I don't think they have school tomorrow, buddy. It's still
summer.
Oh,
because you believe they're smart enough to stay out of summer school. Basically free daycare. I'm sure you have three jobs to pay for all their stupid little needs. Again, shut up. What I should be doing is getting ready for Demo's defense tonight against Exodus Prime. A worthy challenger, but we all know what's going to be the outcome. It's going to be Demo Diamond, 1, 2, 3, and still MPX champion, Demo Diamond.
Well, that remains to be seen. That will be our main event, but Jamie Oller obviously out here to address the allegations, and we've all heard him, we've seen him on social media, that he has had something to do with shiesty mob. We saw the picture that our ringside photographer Brian Pulver took as you and I, Matt, were both lying down on ringside after getting attacked.
The best thing you can hope for is that Ernie can get over here before I slap the taste out of your mouth.
And now Oller's pissed at Brian Pulver for taking a picture doing his job. The reason he's here.
Snitches get stitches, bitch.
It'll be interesting to see, Matt, if we see or hear from the shiesty mob during the MPX Championship match tonight. Okay, I believe you. I believe you. Jamie says it wasn't him.
Yeah, well,
I don't know
that
I believe him, I'll be honest.
I was unconscious. I didn't actually see that picture.
We're going to talk a lot more about the shiesty mob against Tatum Manning. We'll be calling them out later on after their interference in his main event title match. And if I'm Exodus Prime, I'm worried about what might happen during my title match later on tonight. But speaking of titles, back to the semifinals of this women's tournament we have going on here. We just saw Morgan Mercy advance moments ago. Will she be facing this woman here, or will it be Shay Carmichael?
The following contest is a semifinals match in the tournament to determine the number one contender for the MPX Women's Championship. Introducing first, from Porterville, California, Erica Torres!
We saw Erica Torres in action last week against Angel Blue, forcing Angel Blue to tap out. And Angel Blue had said before the match that if she couldn't get it done, that she was going to give up. And I have not heard or seen from Angel Blue since then. But Torres was victorious. Therefore, Torres is in this tournament. Angel Blue is not. As Erica Torres wants to make her way back to the MPX Women's Championship. But she's got to get past this woman, America's sweetheart. Shay Carmichael with a huge opportunity tonight.
And her opponent from Fort Smith, Arkansas, she is America's sweetheart, Shay Carmichael.
Shay Carmichael, Erica Torres set to go one-on-one. You have to believe that Morgan Mercy is somewhere in the back, convalescing, watching this match on a monitor, waiting to see who her opponent will be. Now, Matt, I was just telling the Addicts, we saw Erica Torres victorious last week, dominant. Do you give her the advantage here tonight against Shay Carmichael?
I give Erica Torres the advantage because we've seen her more than any other woman competitor in MPX since the inception of the MPX Women's Championship.
Well, and no matter what happens, Erica Torres' name is always going to be in the history books as the first ever MPX Women's Champion. She wants to be the third as well.
And she looked fantastic last week against Angel Blue, pushing Angel Blue almost to the point, potentially, of retirement. We don't actually know the fallout from it.
Yeah, that's right. She said she was going to give up, and she looked very dejected and defeated after losing that match last week.
And nobody's heard anything from Angel Blue, and you got to wonder if that's the last time that we see Angel Blue in the MPX ring. But let's focus on the match at hand.
Well, Carmichael dropping those knees. And now charge in. And to your point you made during the first match, again, you have to believe both Carmichael and Torres going to try to end this match as quickly as possible because you don't want to go into a match against Morgan Mercy not at 100%.
And I know Erica Torres knows that. Torres has been around for years and years and years. Carmichael has gained a lot of experience in a lot of short time recently, too. But Torres is a very savvy veteran, you know that.
Both women fighting on the outside. I got to be careful. Don't want to double count out here because you don't want to just hand this victory, this tournament to Morgan Mercy, as I think.
They just broke through the wall again.
Well, someone's not going to be happy about that. But
I wonder who that is.
Erica Torres does not care. She doesn't care about your walls. She doesn't care about your bones.
She doesn't really care about a whole lot except throwing women around. I know that's a lot of hashtags that she puts on her social media posts, but I can definitely decipher some of them as throwing women around. That's her shtick.
As Torres stomping away at Carmichael, looking to set her up for that Black Oleander, the same move she made Angel Blue tap out to last week. And Torres trying to muscle Carmichael into the corner.
I was going to say, the same move that she won the MPX Women's Championship with.
Absolutely. As now perching Carmichael, that top turnbuckle.
Shay was in that tournament too, though. Chip on her shoulder perhaps.
And look at the power of Torres. We've seen this before. Oklahoma Stampede dropping Carmichael center of the ring. And is that going to be enough right here? Is Torres advancing just like that? No, only two.
It's going to be a really interesting match if Erica Torres ends up moving on. And I know I'm just speculating, but a power versus power game, watching Erica Torres versus Morgan Mercy, that'd be fantastic.
Do you think Morgan Mercy has any preference as to who she faces?
I think Morgan Mercy, as the heavy metal maiden, really just wants to destroy heads.
And now Carmichael, nice pinning combination, shoulders down, only two.
Thought she was going with it for a camel clutch there, but ended up turning it into a pin.
Well, I think if Shay Carmichael wants to win this match, she has to do what she just did there. She needs to try to catch Erica Torres by surprise.
And that's going to be really hard. As we mentioned, Torres has so many years of experience. She's definitely not new to the game.
Carmichael sitting in the corner. And now Torres very methodically taking her time. And this is normally what we see out of Torres, but again, when you know if you want to win this match, you're going to have to wrestle later on tonight. I don't think you can take your time like Torres is doing. I think you got to stay on your opponent.
But we all know that this is Torres's game, right? She's slow. She's methodical. She definitely likes to pick her opponents apart and throw them around.
As we are seeing here with Carmichael. Now Torres with a cover. Failing to hook the leg, only a two count.
So many deliberate motions from Erica Torres. Nary a wasted movement, although I do think she potentially took a little bit too long on that cover to try to end this match.
And we talked about our main event coming up, Exodus Prime Demo Diamond. Talked about Tata Manning calling out the Shiesty Mob. Match we haven't talked about, big tag match we're going to see later on tonight. House Sagan, Dave Sagan, and Sonny Chambers taking on the duo of JoJo and Sky De La Cremosa. Never thought I'd be uttering those words.
You've got people that like to just roughhouse and throw weapons around, and you know, JoJo's an experienced hardcore match person now, having thrown Kari Wright into the dumpster.
Oh,
goodness.
Suplex in the corner from Carmichael. Looking to turn the tide, so to speak.
You mentioned Shea needing to find a mistake from Erica Torres. That might have been it.
And now Carmichael, both knees in the corner.
There we go.
And not going for cover. Instead, Carmichael looking to go up top.
Probably a mistake, honestly, in my opinion.
Well, and Torres already getting back to her feet. Carmichael, yeah. That crossbody, she got caught. And now Torres trying to get up on the shoulder. She did.
Oh, God. And there she goes.
We saw this last week, this running Samoan drop. And this could be a prelude to the Black Oleander.
Yeah, again, another signature move. And it's cover. Wow, Shea just barely getting that shoulder up.
And as you see, Torres trying to put Carmichael away.
Again, yeah, knowing all the fight from Shea.
Well, and knowing that if she wins this match, she's in for a hell of a fight with Morgan Mercy later tonight.
Both of them are. There's no doubt about that. But Erica may be thinking that she's got the upper hand on Shea. Maybe she's going slow to conserve her energy, you know? Still put on a show, still make a point, still let Morgan Mercy know that Erica Torres is here to throw people around, but taking her time and conserving her energy so that she can do it later.
Well, and Carmichael with a handful of hair following up with that spinning back fist. And now clothesline down goes Torres, but she's not staying down. There's another one. And Carmichael looking to build some momentum, taking the knee out.
Oh, and another stiff kick to the jaw.
DDT on Torres.
That's the way to get Torres off.
And Carmichael floats over into the cover, only two.
Wow, Torres with that shoulder barely up, but she's got to be dazed after that DDT.
But this is what Carmichael needs to do if she wants any shot of getting the victory here.
Well, she's got to keep going, too. Almost Rude Awakening style neckbreaker right there, but Torres gets her back in the corner.
Yeah, driving her into the corner. That shoulder thrust to the midsection, and now, again, more power on display. Torture rack on Carmichael.
This is a problem.
And that torture rack neck breaker.
That's got to be it.
Is that going to be enough? Torres advances.
Here is your winner.
And Matt, we now have it narrowed down to two. It will either be Morgan Mercy or that woman right there, Erica Torres, moving on to face Hilda next week for the MPX Women's title.
The term slugfest is so much of an understatement when you think about Erica Torres against Morgan Mercy tonight.
And Torres going into this match with Mercy later on, Matt, building a wave of momentum. We talked about the victory last week against Angel Blue. Good victory for her here tonight against Shea Carmichael. Can she carry over this momentum and do the same to Morgan Mercy? We're going to find out later on tonight.
Looking forward to it.
Much more still to come here at MPX's Shock and Awesome. One of our biggest shows of the year coming up August 31st. MPX's Purple Rain. MPX's Shock and Awesome on this Thursday night continues. Thank you everyone for watching. No matter where you are in the world, we appreciate all the MPX addicts as always. And right now we are set for triple threat action as the reincarnation of excellence, Kari Wright, about to make his way to the ring. You know, Kari Wright, as of late, he's been looking for that one big victory, that one win to get him back on the path, perhaps to another MPX title match. But it's been a rough go for Kari Wright as of late.
The following contest is a triple threat match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Arlington, Texas, the reincarnation of excellence, Kari Wright!
Kari Wright knows he strings together a couple of victories. He can impress MPX management and get a title shot, perhaps. But he's got to get past not one opponent here tonight, but two. And here's a man that the last couple of weeks has suffered multiple beatings at the hands of the Shiesty Mob. He wasn't alone. Again, if you missed last week, I implore you to go back when this show is over and watch here on Twitch. Shiesty Mob laid waste to everyone. The show was over. We had gone off the air. I was trying to help people out. They came back out, attacked me, attacked Matt Andrews, attacked Tyler Foster, which again is why, one of the reasons why Tyler not here tonight. Dylan Kamen not letting it stop him from being here in action.
And his opponent's first, from the brilliant streets of 2518,
just a one-on-one contest between Kari Wright and Dylan Cavins, I'd be very excited about this great athletic contest and what a great match that would be. But when you add in this third competitor, it amps it up another notch, in my opinion. A young man who's trying to put some wins together of his own. He's been making a name for himself here the last several weeks, impressing a lot of the MPX addicts. And of course, I'm talking about the Cowabunga Kid, Adam Green. Adam Green, he's another one that ran out here trying to fight off the Shiesty Mob last week. So of course, Adam Green, the competitor in this match with the least experience, going up against the veteran Kari Wright, and one of the most loved athletes here in MPX, Dylan Cavins. Adam Green, Dylan Cavins, Kari Wright here in this triple threat match. Being joined once again by Matt Andrews. Matt, who do you give the advantage to in this match? You know, you've been here at MPX as our arena announcer for quite some time now, ever since March, I believe. You've had plenty of experience. Yes, since Destiny. You've seen all three of these guys in action quite a bit. Who do you think has the upper hand?
I'll tell you my answer plain and clear, Cody Cox. I give the advantage to Kari Wright. Do you want to know why?
Yes, please tell me.
Kari Wright has not had to deal with the Shiesty Mob.
Well, and we were talking about that as both Adam Green and Dylan Cavins made their way to the ring I think there's a reason Corey Wright has not had to deal with the Shiesty mob.
Well, your reasoning might be correct, but oh, quick roll-up. Not a bad strategy by Adam trying to get the win early.
Look, this group of individuals, and we still don't know who they are yet. They've all been masked. There's been speculation over the last week or so. Other addicts have named names. I'm not going to do that because I don't know if it's true or not. I don't want anyone coming after me or suing me like Jamie Aller threatened earlier. Nice cover from Adam Green.
There's going to be a lot of fast pacing in this, Cody, so we're going to have to be on our toes a little bit.
Dellen Cavins, the fastest man in MPX, as Green went for that. Wait a second.
Uh-oh.
And again, look at the redirect from Cavins through the legs of Green. And I don't know if Adam Green in his young career has been in the ring yet with anyone quite as fast as Dellen Cavins.
No, usually Adam Green's the lightest person in the match, and he's also one of the fastest, one of the most high-flying.
Cover!
That might not be the case here tonight. Still, Green has put an impressive resume together in his time here at MPX. Remember at the Purge, teaming with Santana Jackson, obviously, to defeat the Boy Band Behemoth and all of his guys. Oh, and a ridiculous clothesline by Corey Wright right there, and that is going to change the momentum of this match entirely.
Corey Wright, of course, the only man in this match to be a former MPX champion. As now pulling that arm of Cavins through the leg. Looking to hook him here. Oh no, Cavins lands on his feet. Nice duck on her, looking for a backslide. But Corey
too tall. Way too tall for this move.
Gets Cavins over. Cavins back on his feet on a poke to the eyes.
Hey, it's all legal. No rules in that triple threat match.
That is correct. And now down across the knee. That's what he was looking for earlier. Looking to get the victory right here, but Adam Green and they're attempting to break it up. Corey saw him coming.
Awkward.
And now Corey with the right hand.
Corey's going to have a hard time slowing the match down to hit pace that he likes because Adam Green and Dellen Cavins are both ridiculously fast.
And what an upset. What a victory it would be for Adam Green here tonight, especially if he's able to get the victory by pinning a former MPX champion in Corey Wright. Corey sent in. Nice redirect from Corey. Deep arm drag from Green.
That's what I love about Adam Green. He's so high-flying, but he has so much old school in him. Definitely a throwback to the Rockers, obviously, right?
Absolutely. And now Corey spun around. And you see Cavins over in the corner getting some rest as Adam Green slamming Corey center of the ring. And we're going to get radical here tonight. Springboard moonsault on Corey. Is Green going to pick up the victory here? And Cavins was almost going to be just a slight second too late.
That quebrada by Green, obviously just a fantastic mix of the new school and the old school elements there from Adam Green.
And Corey with the enziguri. From the middle rope, misses with the kick.
I love when he hits that kick, though. Oh, for the rocker dropper, and no!
And down across the back of the head goes the knee of Corey. Here comes Cavins back in. And that tornado kick catching Corey right in the temple. All three men are down. Who's going to gain the upper hand?
Oh, and Cavins.
Cavins with the cover on Green. Two.
So close.
And why not? Let's go for the other individual. And again, only two on Corey.
See, I would have gone the opposite way. I would have gone to go pin Corey first because I had just hit him. He went and got the man that was resting a little bit longer over there in Adam Green.
And now Cavins waiting on Corey to get back to his feet.
He's got to build up that momentum, but giving him that time to rest. Oh.
Well, it might prove to... Oh, he's in the spot for backpack bomb. No, Cavins on his feet. And sent through the ropes. Super kick to the back of the head from Green. Here comes Cavins. No, Green caught him.
Whoa.
And the Cowabunga Kid. Cowabunga! With Cavins up. Spinning Uranagi.
Unbelievable right there. Again, rare that we see Adam Green with a power game, but Dellen Cavins so light.
And I think Green maybe should have gone for the cover. But he wants to go for his patented move. He's been winning matches with the rewind.
Yeah, but that's got to be a little bit of the inexperience there. And is going to be why.
He just got sent face first into the guardrail from Corey Wright.
You might as well count Adam Green out of this match. I think I saw him hit his head.
Oh, Corey was going to try to take advantage. Small packets from Cavins, only two.
That was entirely too close for Corey's liking, I'm sure. Look out.
Drop to hold across that middle rope.
I think we know what's coming up next. A little Tiger Fang kick action, maybe. Oh, Hikaru caught him. Oh, but not the second time around.
And right into the ribs. And Cavens springboard onto the back of Corey, but he got caught. Backpack ball on Cavens. Corey, two. Corey Wright gets the win.
Here is your winner, the reincarnation of excellence, Corey Wright.
Corey Wright picking up a victory here tonight.
And I gotta tell you, I gotta think that Dylan Cavens and Adam Green may be a little too focused on what the Shiesty Mob might be doing here tonight. Corey's head completely in this game into winning this triple threat match.
I think that's a great point, Matt. Again, much as we've seen Cavens and Green deal with the Shiesty Mob, perhaps their minds weren't all into this match, at least not 100% anyways.
Oftentimes, I'll be critical of Corey Wright for being a little too carefree, a little too off aloof. But I think in this case, it actually did him a favor. He didn't have to worry about anybody else around his back because he doesn't care. He's just out here to win his matches.
Corey Wright picking the victory here tonight. Of course, still to come, that big main event for the MPX title. The champion, the Shining Truth, Demo Diamond, alongside Jamie Aller, will go one-on-one. At least we hope it's one-on-one. With the final boss, Exodus Prime, Tatum Manning is going to call out the Shiesty Mob later on tonight. But when we return, it's tag team action. MPX is shocking awesome.
Ready for it to get weird.
MPX Addicts, it's shocking awesome. I'm Cody Cox here at ringside with you, and I still can't get used to calling this man here Sonny Chambers. I got here, I looked at my format sheet earlier today, and I forgot for a second that he was rechristened. I said, who the hell is Sonny Chambers? And then I quickly remembered. The very clean shaven, he got a haircut. He is drinking the Kool-Aid that Dave Sagan is serving him. And here comes Dave. So they can't come out together. Al Sagan can't have one entrance. They gotta have two. We gotta hear two crappy theme songs. Dave Sagan and Sonny Chambers teaming together. No Isaac Mazer here tonight. I tried to find out from Dave Sagan earlier where Isaac Mazer was. He wouldn't give me the time of day. Of course, we've seen Sagan and Chambers team here in the past. We saw them team back at the Purge. But Dave Sagan has picked quite the fight and quite the war with Sky De La Cremosa. We saw what Sagan did to De La Cremosa's good friend Dmitry Alexandrov several weeks back, trying to break his neck in a steel chair. And you better believe Sky De La Cremosa cannot wait to get his hands on any member of House Sagan tonight.
The following is a tag team contest set for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, claiming a residence in Sunsayame Refuge Resort in the heart of Nunu Atoll, overlooking the Indian Ocean. The team of the son of Sagan, Sonny Chambers, and Dave Sagan, House Sagan.
House Sagan, Dave Sagan, and Sonny Chambers taking on the very interesting, very unique duo of Sky De La Cremosa and JoJo. We'll see how those two get along. And the familiar music of Cash All Enterprises. And Alex, I'm here to tell you, and this is legit, JoJo smells awful. For some reason, he smelled like motor oil earlier. I don't know if Monte Cashall is making him bathe in the stuff or what. I still trust Monte Cashall. Don't like Monte Cashall. But the addicts have been taking a liking to JoJo. I would probably like him better if Monte would let him take a shower. JoJo getting a handful of popcorn, trying to get food at any point, whenever he can.
And their opponents first, coming into the ring by Monte Cashall Esquire, from the mean streets of downtown Miami, JoJo!
See, Matt Adder is covering his nose again. JoJo smells awful. I don't feel bad for Sagan and Chambers having to be in there with him. They brought all this on themselves. And I do feel bad, though, for Sky De La Cremosa having a team with a man that bathed in motor oil. You know, maybe Isaac Mazur isn't here tonight because he didn't want to be in the vicinity of Sky De La Cremosa. I don't know that for certain, but I'm just going to run with it.
And his tag team partner from Weeping Mary, Texas, the Texas Chainsaw Sky De La Cremosa.
Sky De La Cremosa and JoJo, who made quite the interesting tag team. De La Cremosa's been known to eat flesh, and JoJo, he just wants to eat. Wait a second.
Sky. You know what, Sky? It didn't have to be like this. It didn't have to go down the way it's going down, but I get it. Because here's the thing, Sky. This isn't Hal Sagan's fault that it's come to this. This isn't Sonny Chambers' fault. It's not my fault. And it's certainly not Isaac Mazur's fault, Sky. Because the truth is, this is your fault. Sky, you are a sick, sick man. You're mentally ill, Sky. Yeah, and of course, they cheer you, the MPX addicts, because what are addicts? They are sick people, too. But here's the thing, Sky. See Sonny Chambers right here? Do you see what we did to him? Sky, De La Cremosa, the monster, I can fix you. I can make you better, Sky. I can make all of you better. You're suffering from the monster mind virus.
We're gonna have a match.
So, Sky, I know this match is gonna happen tonight, but here's what I'm gonna put on the table. We want you to step into the sun. We want Sky De Lacrimosa in house singing!
Sky De Lacrimosa wants to take a chainsaw to house singing.
So, Sky, look at me. Look at me. I don't need your answer tonight. But I want you to think about it, okay? Sky De Lacrimosa, Dave Sagan, Sonny Chambers, Isaac Mazur, the new house Sagan. All you have to do is take our hand and step into the sun.
Sagan better be careful that De Lacrimosa doesn't bite the hand. I can't imagine Sky De Lacrimosa taking Dave Sagan up on that offer. Well, De Lacrimosa's gonna get a haircut, he's gonna shave. Come out here dressed like a douchebag. Matt Andrews, I was just telling you, I can't imagine Sky De Lacrimosa ever accepting any kind of offer from Dave Sagan.
I had to stifle my laughter at Sagan trying to channel his inner Coldplay and trying to say, I'll fix you. To Sky De Lacrimosa, I can't.
No, it'll never happen. Any truth to the rumor that I just started that Isaac Mazur is not here tonight because he's scared of Sky De Lacrimosa?
You know, I might have seen something in his eyes last time they encountered where there was a little bit of the emotion of fear.
But now it's JoJo getting the hell stomped out of him by both Chambers and Sagan.
There must be a little fear in JoJo's eyes right now, although when he came out...
No, that's just hunger.
That's fair.
And I think it's also his eyes tearing up from the fumes of the motor oil he bathed in earlier tonight.
Yeah, he was telling me that he bathed earlier, but I asked him what he did. He said soap. And I looked down.
No.
And I think he thought it might have been charcoal soap. I'm not sure, but it might have just been charcoal.
Sagan and Chambers already taking it to JoJo in the early seconds of this matchup. Clubbing forearm from Chambers.
Yeah, going back to your point, I wonder how much of a factor it is that Isaac Mazur is not here. Now, I'm no emotion in Inside Out, but I got to wonder what is inside Isaac Mazur's head as he sends his two compatriots out here.
And JoJo in desperate need of a tag already as De Lacrimosa won in this match very badly.
Hear how loud the MPX Addicts are cheering for JoJo, for this guy that we can smell coming a mile away.
And despite the fact that he smells, they still like him. That says something about our Addicts, and that's a good thing.
Of course. They fight from the ground up. They never quit. They'll swing with everything they got.
Yeah,
that's what you mean, right?
Pull yourself up with your bootstraps, that sort of thing, right?
I'm not sure he's got bootstraps.
No, I think he's got duct tape around his boots, perhaps.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll pull himself up with the gorilla tape.
Not
but
exactly
now look, and like it or not, and look, I've said a lot of crap over the last few months about how Sagan and Chambers working extremely well right now as a tag team.
Obviously some of the tutelage under House Sagan. Gotta wonder how many times Chambers has taken Dave's hand in a training environment and learned from one of the very best that MPX has ever seen.
Look, the guys are definitely on the same page here tonight as JoJo trying to reach out and tag. I was gonna say maybe getting some words of encouragement from Monty Cashall. I don't know if Monty Cashall ever gives words of encouragement or not.
I think he just says that you're not going to get paid.
Yeah, I think he's threatening to withhold food.
That's, and you know, if that's encouragement, that's encouragement. We all find it in different ways. That's some of my own tutelage there. Maybe I should start my own house.
And you hear these loud Addicts here at the MPX Event Center on a Thursday night. We appreciate them coming out and being with us here on Thursday. We appreciate you guys watching anywhere around the world. As Sagan tags back in.
And again, cutting off the ring, a classic tag team action, and Dave has been in his share of tag teams. So is Red Chambers, of course, former champions, and they know exactly how to wrestle this. JoJo has not been in a whole lot of tag teams, right? So, the advantage clearly is going to go to House Sagan.
And Dave Sagan is stomping at the back of JoJo's head.
Look, I know it looks like he's missing those, but he's grazing the top of JoJo's head. And that can hurt sometimes as much as a direct kick to the head. Feeling the skin scrape off of the top of your head with that
cover,
that can hurt almost as much.
And now Sagan keeping JoJo grounded.
Cody, I gotta ask you. There was a shift in strategy by House Sega. A few weeks ago, it was Isaac Mazur saying that they're ready for Sky De La Cremosa. And tonight, Dave Sagan offering his hand in partnership. And I got to tell you, I wonder if Sagan noticed something in Sky tonight. Sky didn't bring out his trademark bat. I don't know if maybe there's something softening in Sky, or is that,
I've known Sky De La Cremosa a long time. I can't imagine that being the case, especially, and I mentioned it earlier, especially after what happened to his good friend Dimitri Alexander a few weeks ago. But there's the tag to De La Cremosa.
Wow, that's a great smile on the face of Sky, I gotta say. He looks really happy to be in there.
And Dave Sagan begging off.
Sky taking a lot of time there.
And Chambers trying to distract the referee. Oh, Sagan was going to go for a low blow. We've seen him do that before.
I'm not sure if that's exactly where they want to take the hand of Sagan.
And De La Cremosa, stiff headbutt to Sagan.
Wow. We were talking about Morgan Mercy and her headbutts earlier. Sky doesn't feel anything in the head at all.
Stiff forearm to the leader of House Sagan. Back into the ropes, and Sagan can barely stand right now. And here comes Chambers. No tag. Get him out of there, Trueborn.
Storied history here with Sky, and oh man, what a great way to take advantage. Sky took his eye off the ball.
And now Chambers right across the back, and you're right, Matt. Sky De La Cremosa teamed with Red Chambers on a number of occasions, so it has to be weird for De La Cremosa to look across this ring and see someone that he barely recognizes.
They had a fantastic hardcore match here at MPX months ago, just around the time that I joined, and there was so much mutual admiration and respect between those two. I don't know if that's the same Chambers that we're seeing.
Well, that's when De La Cremosa was doing his open challenges, and here comes Chambers from behind. So obviously, Sonny Chambers, I still can't get used to saying Sonny.
It's really weird.
Sonny Chambers knows De La Cremosa extremely well.
Well, Red Chambers does. I don't know if Sonny even knows Sky right now.
Flying clothesline from that middle turnbuckle. Going for a cover, lateral press, only a one count. And now Chambers really taking it to De La Cremosa.
Did you notice the slight hesitation? Chambers looked back over his shoulder before he went for that pinfall, maybe looking for Isaac Mazur. It's got to be a little weird not seeing your mentor in the corner.
Wherever Mazur is, I have to believe he's looking on.
Maybe he's tanning somewhere. I feel like he needs it. For all the tutelage the Sagan gives, he doesn't seem to be passing on any of his tanning secrets to either Chambers or Mazur.
And now Chambers with that knee right to the top of De La Cremosa's head. And you know, De La Cremosa got the tag in this match, came in like a house of fire, but just like that, in a matter of seconds, Matt, it's House Sagan in full control again.
And this, I don't know, this is really weird seeing Sky in this position, right? I mean, he's not in a hardcore environment, obviously. He is a skilled wrestler, but seeing him down like this is very uncharacteristic. It's very weird. Oh.
And Chambers getting in the face of JoJo, trying to provide a distraction.
Sure, provoke a
hold. And that's exactly why, so we could choke De La Cremosa, even if only for a second.
Sky looks really worn down here.
Well, he is. He suffered a lot of punishment here in this match at the hands of both Chambers and Sagan. And Chambers being warned by the official. Keep your eye on Sagan. And Sagan with that kick. Any split second that Sagan or Chambers gets the chance to do something behind the referee's back, you better believe they're going to take advantage.
Trueborn has a really, really bad habit of turning around, putting his back to the end.
Look, Trueborn's got a lot of bad habits. Don't get me started. It's now Chambers and Sagan again in full control. By the way, still to come, of course, main event, MPX Championship on the line, Demo Diamond versus Exodus Prime. We will crown a new number one contender for the Women's Championship. It'll either be Morgan Mercy or Erica Torres as De La Cremosa runs Sagan over with that shoulder tackle.
Yeah, that was like a freight train. And see, there we go again. A headbutt and Sky is back at it. It's
almost
might
be looking for death by stereo. Can he get him up? No, Sagan driving De La Cremosa into the corner, but it's the wrong corner as JoJo tags himself in. And Sagan had the chance to tag, elected not to. Here comes Chambers illegally, and JoJo taking it to everybody.
This is JoJo's MO right here, fighting from the streets.
One thing about JoJo, you make him mad, he's going to beat the ever-loving hell out of you. And that's what he's doing right now to both members of House Sagan. And I'm not saying it's right, but I think when Monty Cashall holds meals from JoJo, it makes him even angrier. It makes him a better fighter. Still not saying he should do that. There's probably better ways to motivate JoJo, but that's what we're seeing here.
Look, it's working. JoJo's been on a winning streak, and he's got food on the table. I think it works out just fine. It's not pretty, but nothing about JoJo is, but he's getting the job done.
But Sagan with that backbreaker, and now that we've seen this several times where either Dale Hermosa or JoJo gets tagged in, and they come in, and then with a matter of seconds, it's back to House Sagan being in control.
That just goes to show the veteran in-ring presence of Dave Sagan, both in the tutelage of Red Chambers, who's no rookie, by the way. Let's get that.
Both. Oh, and JoJo just threw his entire body at Dave Sagan, and can he make the tag?
I can't even call that a spinning heel.
There's De La Cremosa, and Sagan not tagging out to Chambers. Right hand from De La Cremosa, and now Chambers tagging himself in. Sky with a clothesline. Huge boot right to the chest. Oh, and Sagan.
I don't know if he was going to try to offer the hand again.
Sagan getting the hell out of there. And Chambers from behind. And look at Sagan cowering up here on the ramp.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was such a wise move. Chambers didn't get any part of any kind of lock held in on De La Cremosa.
And now, gut wrench powerbomb.
Wow.
That might do it. And Sagan looks like he wants no part of De La Cremosa.
Meanwhile, JoJo wants nothing more than to get in. I don't know. That might have been a mistake. A huge doctor bomb like that.
And now JoJo bringing Chambers back to his feet.
Oh, man. And you don't know how many holes are in that boot. He could have stepped on a toe.
And now Chambers with several right hands. Not sure they're having any effect on JoJo.
Speaking of not feeling anything in the head. Looks like he's hoboing up.
And now, several right hands from JoJo. He's got Chambers on the ropes.
Sagan hasn't gone up on the apron at all.
Irish whip, another kick to the chest. Things are not going the way Dave Sagan wanted tonight. Things are crashing and burning all around House Sagan. And JoJo dropping the leg, brother. But again, no cover. De La Cremosa wants some more of Chambers.
I think the fact that they're not going for a cover is going to come
back. Oh, Sagan up on the apron now, pleading with De La Cremosa.
Yeah, I'm not sure that's going to do much good.
Death by stereo on Chambers. Sky with the cover, and Sagan not breaking it up.
Here are your winners, the team of JoJo and the Texas Chainsaw.
Cremosa and JoJo are your winners.
No thanks to Dave Sagan, that's for sure.
Yeah, Sagan had the chance to stop that three count. Elected not to, and I think maybe he just saw the writing on the wall.
Sagan spent the last 3 or 4 minutes of that match on the floor.
And how Sagan wanting to live to find another day, maybe regroup with Isaac Mazur. But you better believe things are far from over between Dave Sagan and Sky De La Cremosa.
How much food do you think is going to be on JoJo's plate tonight?
Your guess is as good as mine. Alex, much more action still to come. When we return, Tata Manning is going to be with us. He's going to be calling out the Shiesty Mob. I don't know how safe I'm going to feel here at ringside with the Shiesty Mob with us. And Tata Manning, a very brave soul, because who knows how many members of the Shiesty Mob are here tonight. Much more, we return to MPX's Shock and Awesome. MPX Addicts, we continue here. Twitch.tv/MetroplexWrestling with MPX's Shock and Awesome on this Thursday night. A reminder, we will be back here next Thursday, and we already know the MPX Women's Championship will be on the line, as Hilda will go one-on-one with either Erica Torres or Morgan Marcy. We're going to find out in just a little bit who that's going to be. But right now, the man that thought he was going to leave here last week as MPX champion, Tatum Manning, he's been saying all week on social media, he's calling out the Shiesty mob. I admire the guts of Tatum Manning. I admire the bravery. I don't know how smart that is. The Shiesty mob laid waste to everyone they came across last week, including yours truly, including Matt Andrews.
MPX Addicts, please welcome One in a Million, Tatum Manning!
And including Tyler Foster as well, if you're just joining us. No Tyler Foster this week. Again, I talked to him earlier. He's feeling fine after the meeting. We're all a little bit sore. He could have been here. Said he did not feel safe to show up here tonight, as long as he knew Shiesty mob was going to be in the house. And we found out last week before all the beatdowns that there was some sort of deal made with Shiesty mob. That's why they have entrance music. That's why they have a video. And these guys right here, I don't know any of their names. We don't know what they look like. The one in the middle, I believe, is the one I spoke to last week. He's also the one that sucker punched me last week, by the way. And there's been speculation all week long as to who these men are. I've heard various names thrown out. I cannot confirm any of them.
And introducing the Shiesty mob. Cut that stupid ass music. Cut their music. Oh, come on. Come on. Come down the line, boys. Come on. This is what you wanted, right? This is what you wanted. Yeah, go on, take your long walk. Talk all your smack. Look at the faces of the people you disrespected last week. Look at this goofy ass mob. Now listen, boys, what I've been told since Saturday night is that y'all's justification for what you did last week is that y'all want opportunities. Is that right? Okay, that's fine. Hell, if anybody can understand what an opportunity, it's me. But what I have absolutely zero respect for is the way that y'all went about it. Y'all want to slide in the middle of this ring during last week's main event and cost me the MPX championship? You want to beat my ass, huh? You want to curb stomp me on a chair, little man? Yeah, keep nodding your head. Keep nodding. That's fine. You want to try to give me a concussion, send me to the ER? Fine. But y'all didn't stop there. Y'all didn't stop there. You took it a step too far. You see, you started attacking the people who work here and help run this company. You took it upon yourselves to attack referee Carl Knight, who can't even be here tonight because of what you did to him. You want to attack our camera people. Langley, Zephyr, she ain't do a damn thing to any of you. So that's how you're going about trying to get your opportunities. Is that right? Okay. All right. Well, then whichever one of you wants to step in this ring with me, come on ahead. I'll wait for you. And I'll wait all damn night if you make me.
And it'll be interesting to see which one. Again, I don't know their name, so I can't say, oh, yeah, this one's going to be against Manny. It's this all guy right here.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right. You know what? Before we ring this bell and get this show on the road, brother, you're going to take that damn mask off, and you're going to show everybody here exactly what kind of a person you are. And nothing's gonna happen until you do it. So I suggest you take off the mask.
Let's do it. I wanna see who it is. I wanna see if any of the rumors are true. And it looks like he's gonna do it, the mask. The mask is coming off. And I don't know who the hell that is.
Damn, that was anticlimactic, wasn't it?
Tatum Manning took the word.
Listen, bro, I don't know who the hell you are, but to each and every person who showed up here tonight, you're just the next guy who's going to get his ass handed to him by Tatum Manning. Ring the bell.
So Manning took the words out of my mouth. We still don't know who this guy is. I guess it's fine that we know what he looks like. And of course, again, we've been hearing rumors who some of these guys are. And I'm surprised, as Matt joins me back on commentary, that there's only three of them out here. We know there are more of these guys. Are they elsewhere in the building? Are they hiding somewhere?
I don't even know how many more that there are, but Cody, I got to tell you, from flashbacks to my retirement match, I had some definite thoughts as to who it might be, and I'm really glad that it wasn't. I just don't know who this is right now.
Yeah, I have no clue. I don't know this individual's name. I've never seen him here before.
It doesn't look like Tatum Manning much cares as to who he actually is.
Manning,
and quite frankly, I don't either.
Manning does not care as he's stomping the hell out of this guy. And a lot of times it helps to be able to call the action in a wrestling match
to know
when you know someone's name, but it's just going to be Manning and the other guy.
Shiesty one.
Huge right hand for Manning.
Or is the small guy Shiesty one?
Whips him into the ropes, and of course you've got the other two. And look, the other two members of the Shiesty mob pulling the third, the unmasked member, to safety.
Wouldn't that normally result in a disqualification? He technically just touched his legs out from him. Bring it back in the ring. I wonder what kind of ring knowledge these guys actually have. We don't know who they are. And it's great the guy could jump into the ring, but you know, so can I.
Oh, wait a second, look. This individual up on the apron.
That's the one you talked to last week, Cody.
And he's also the one that sucker punched me. And here comes this guy, the unmasked, the one that's in the match.
Shiesty too.
Attacking Manning from behind.
I mean, should we expect anything different from this crowd? Attacking from behind? No, probably not.
That forearm shot to the back of Manning. You know, Tatum Manning, he suffered quite the beating last week. I'm surprised he's even able to compete tonight after everything that went down with the Shiesty mob and Manning.
It was a potential concussion. Doesn't look like it actually was one, or else you got to think he wouldn't actually be clear tonight.
Now, lots of people weren't clear tonight. One of our camera operators, Zephyr, she's not here tonight. She was taken to a medical facility after the show last week, referee Carl Knight.
Yeah. And, of course, we mentioned Tyler Foster, who just is scared.
And I can't say I blame Tyler. I don't agree with a lot Tyler says and does. But, you know, I had thoughts of not showing up here tonight as well. I didn't know what was going to happen.
Cody, you've suffered a lot worse. The hands
have
a lot worse. I mean, we just saw a couple of them earlier in House Sagan, and you're still here. But this is a completely different entity altogether, the Shiesty mob. No idea, no knowledge of who they are. We can't really say.
And again, one of them up on the apron, and I don't know if that one's the leader or not. He's the one that certainly does the most talking.
You got to give credit to Tatum Manning for calling out the whole mob, but you also got to wonder, why wouldn't he...
Oh!
Why wouldn't he bring backup?
And the Shiesty mob member ran into that huge right hand, and now Manning... Ducks the backhand. Oh, springboard stunner.
That's a little scorny.
Manning with the springboard stunner. Looking to get the win here in this Shiesty mob member's very first match here in MPX. And again, the other members of Shiesty mob pulling him to safety. Now Manning, he's seen enough. He's calling for the microphone again.
Said stop counting. Getting real tired of this, man. I've done this too many times. Too many factions, too many groups, too many big bad wolves. I know how this goes. Hell, I was there when it was written, brothers. So you know what? Seth, if we can find some common ground and be in agreement, I say we take the rule book and we throw it out the window. And we save all the theatrics, all the bullshit, and we make this no disqualification, no countouts, anything goes. You damn right it's what I want. Y'all want a piece of me? Whoever wants some, get in this ring and come get some. Sound good?
Look, I know Manning is upset. I don't know if this is such a smart move. I mean, this is basically going to be 3-on-1.
This contest is now a no disqualification match.
But Manny's got to contend with all three members of the Shiesty Mob. And now, bringing the two masked ones in. And a DDT on the... Again, I don't know if that guy's the leader or not.
I don't know how smart this was by Manny. I mean, and there's part of it, but look, he's been great for now, but he came out of House of Fire. He took out two members of it, but I gotta say, this isn't a smart move by one in a million.
Look, and these guys, the Shiesty Mob, they've said they're doing this. They want opportunities. You know, there's a way about going about getting opportunities. Guys like Tatum Manning, Exodus Prime, who we're gonna see later on tonight. Even guys that I don't always like and agree with. Guys like Kari Wright. They've gone the right way about getting opportunities, earning them in the ring. These guys think they're just gonna walk in here and get opportunities handed to them by beating the hell out of people. Cover.
Well, look, once upon a time in MPX history, there were several individuals that went about this exact same way, trying to get their opportunities and jumping in unannounced. It's not a terrible strategy. One I might not agree with right now, but I kind of respect it.
Oh, and Manny just...
kind of respect that, too.
Spat water in the face of his opponent. The other two are still on the outside, and again, no DQ.
Yeah, I questioned their ring knowledge earlier, and if it's no DQ, and I'm part of the people on the outside, as Manning kicks out of that bridging suplex right there, I gotta say, if I'm part of the Shiesty Mob, I'm going in and I'm beating him up. I don't think there's any honor here. If you're part of the Shiesty Mob, just go in and beat the heck out of him. So I don't know how smart these guys are right now.
And now Manning on the defensive. Getting choked in the corner. And obviously whoever this guy is has some sort of wrestling background, some training. He's holding his own, of course.
Well, and it looks like the leader right there was taking advantage of the no DQ rule. But again, there should be weapons in this ring right now. There should be chairs. There should be doors, tables. Both of them should be in here beating the heck out of Manning. This clearly is not about any kind of victories. This is about getting your name out there. And them trying for a pinfall is a little weird to me.
And that forearm shot to Manning. They were on the top turnbuckle. And now... this guy doing a lot of trash talk.
A lot of trash talk for somebody that has never existed in MPX before.
And looking to put away a former two-time MPX champion. Is Manning fighting back? Headbutt. And now Manning looking to ride the line. But look, the Shiesty Mob member right up there blatantly in front of the referee and nothing. Referee Cedric Scott can do about it.
And this was the bet that Tatum Manning made. He's the one that made this a no disqualification match, and now we're going to see if it pays off. Quick cover here, and a kick out by Manning.
And the addicts echoing the words of Tatum Manning earlier, goofy ass mob.
That's going to be a hashtag later.
But now Manning on the shoulders. Back on his feet. And Manny with a pedigree. Pedigree center of the ring. Is he going to go for a cover? And look, he's looking right at the other Shiesty Mob members.
He knew
here they
coming.
Come.
What a spine buster.
And from the top, Manny caught him one hand. Huge chokeslam from Manning.
That's... something else is up, though. There's no way that the Shiesty Mob would allow this to be done this easily.
Oh, but Manning back on his feet. Spins him around. Clawbreaker! Clawbreaker!
And that's put away so many people here at MPX, but it doesn't look like Manning's able to cover.
Well, not able to take advantage while the other Shiesty Mob members are down. As I think Manning was looking around for them, trying to spot them. And now, Manning looking to ride the lightning.
Yeah, but he had the guy.
Oh, and again! Look! And Manning just got shoved off that top turnbuckle.
He landed right on the back of his neck. That is not a good landing for Tatum Manning. Okay, now here comes that mob mentality.
And now all the members of Shiesty Mob, at least the ones that are here anyways, in the ring, putting the boots to Manning. And again, nothing the referee can do about it. Manning was the one that issued the no DQ challenge. And now it's 3-on-1. And no one even going for a cover.
Hey, there's his reinforcements.
Here comes some help. Cavins, Greens.
And again, how much effectiveness are they going to be at having taken a loss to Kari Wright earlier?
Neither Cavens agreeing strangers to the Shiesty mob, but that leaves Manning alone with the one he's in the match with, another clout breaker. And can Manning go for the cover while the other members are distracted? He's looking around.
Manning's got a look in his eyes, and I kind of think he's taking his eye off of the immediate ball in front of him.
I think you're right, Matt.
Not that I think this whole thing is about wins anyway, but if he wants to end this and make a statement, yeah.
On a low blow! The Shiesty mob member, the low blow, and you see the look on his face, resorting to desperation.
But now what's he going to do?
Well, and he knows none of his other Shiesty mob members are able to come to his aid.
Trying for the third time that move, a detonation
the cover.
Kick.
Oh, come on. Kick out!
That's it.
Damn it.
Here are your winners, the Shiesty mob.
And I think you said it right, even though this technically was not a handicap match, the Shiesty mob, they are the winners.
I mean, until we find out who any of these guys are, that's what they are. Cedric better get out of there.
So the question is, Matt, the other guys underneath the masks, maybe they're not who some of the addicts have rumored. Maybe even if they all unmasked, we wouldn't know who any of them were.
This is a complete unknown, and they're not done yet, Cody. This is not good.
And now, Manning, the triple powerbomb, shades of last week.
If Tatum Manning didn't have a concussion last Saturday, he may have one now.
We got to get these guys out, or we do not want a repeat of what happened last week. As again, Adam Green, Dellen Cavens down on the outside, Manning down in the middle of the ring. Oh, wait a second. Here's another one. Another one just came over the guardrail.
And where did he come from? And what? Where has he been?
He's a little bit late to the party, isn't he? And we now have four members of the Shiesty mob. How many more are there?
And who's the guy that unmasked himself?
And if we don't know who any of them are, why are they even masked?
Look, just because he was late doesn't mean that he gets to do this again.
And now the guy that just showed up, getting in on the action.
I can't even tell. I don't even know who this is.
And look at the power, whoever he is.
Oh my God, a dominator.
Dominating Manning. And still, Matt, we are without answers to who most of these go. Well, really, any of them are. We don't even know who the guy on the right is, even though he unmasked. Hopefully, this is the last we've seen of these guys here tonight. We're going to crown a new number one contender for the NBX Women's title when we return. It's shocking awesome. Continue with our tournament final with the winner of this match facing Hilda next week for the Women's Championship. Erica Torres victorious earlier tonight as she defeated Shea Carmichael to get here. Erica Torres knows what it takes to be the women's champion. She won the tournament for the title when it was first introduced in January of this year. Her opponent, Morgan Mercy, defeated Maya World earlier, and they're not waiting. Morgan Mercy going right after Erica Torres. And I wonder if Mercy perhaps saw that there was a weakness to Torres after her match with Carmichael. Maybe something she's trying to capitalize on,
well,
as she
scary.
Did not want to wait for any introduction. Huge belly-to-belly suplex from Mercy.
And not a terrible strategy by Morgan Mercy right now.
No, not at all. That running senton only in one count. And Hilda knows both of these women extremely well. I have to believe Hilda would not have a preference as to who she would face here next week for the women's title.
No, not at all. And Erica Torres had the second of those two qualifying matches, so maybe Morgan just knows that she has an opportunity to put it away.
Oh, huge German suplex!
And there she goes, tossing women around.
And that power coming into play yet again from Torres. Cover!
But definitely not enough. Mercy kicking out at one.
And now Torres raining down the forearms as Mercy tries to cover up.
There's not going to be a lot of flippy stuff here, Cody. This is going to be slugging, throwing, power on power.
And Torres with the right hand.
And Torres obviously has no compunction about breaking the rules. It's not really a big deal to her.
Now Mercy in the corner trying to create some distance between her and Torres. Immediately following this match, Matt, we will have our main event MPX title on the line. The champion, Demo Diamond, defending against the final boss, Exes Prime. And despite what we've seen in recent weeks from Demo Diamond, like him or not, and I said it last week to Tyler, you got to give Demo Diamond credit. He's been a fighting champion.
He absolutely
has. Tatum Manning this week, or last week, excuse me, Exodus Prime this week. But one has to wonder, we've heard the whisperings, not just from the addicts, but from the people in the locker room as well. Is there a connection between the Shiesty Mob and Jamie Aller? Will we see the Shiesty Mob get involved in the main event? That's the question that remains.
Look
at the power.
We knew it was coming in. The power of Erica Torres is unmatched, no matter what her fatigue level is.
Inside leg hooked, only a two count.
Torres is ready to throw people around. And going back to your point about Demo being a fighting champion, remember, Cody, he's a fighting champion sometimes to the displeasure of Jamie Aller. That first week he came out here and he threw out that challenge, Jamie did not look very pleased with that.
Absolutely, as now Erica Torres is driving the heel of her boot to the back of Morgan Mercy's head.
And let's just say, for instance, the connections with Jamie and the Shiesty Mob are true, and they're looking for opportunity. I'm just saying, as somebody who's been there and has seen people come for opportunity at the MPX Championship, you just gotta wonder.
Well, and speaking of championships again, a lot on the line here in this match.
Honestly, if I'm Hilda, I don't want to face Erica Torres. Erica has faced me before several times. I know Hilda beat Erica to win the MPX Women's Championship.
On a stiff headbutt from Mercy.
Yeah. But you got to imagine, Erica has done her homework. She's a student of the game. She's a student of previous opponents, and she knows what to expect from Hilda now.
And Mercy bringing Torres out of the corner. Torres back to her feet. STO for Mercy, nicely done.
Might have surprised Torres a little bit because it wasn't a strike. It wasn't anything that used Mercy's head or fist.
And that forearm shot rocks Torres as now Mercy.
A little throwing of her own maybe.
Snap her out of the corner. And that roundhouse kick connecting, I believe, to the shoulder of Torres. But Mercy not going for a cover.
Cody, I'm not sure you see it on the cameras or anything, but when I'm...
Senton down across the back all the way to Mercy. That's over 200 pounds. Only two.
2,000 pounds of heavy metal, by the way. But when I was in there announcing Erica Torres and she walked by me, she has a massive bruise on her right shoulder. Maybe that's something that Morgan is clued in on and is trying to take advantage of.
Well, and that's the thing. When you compete in these one-night tournaments, you run the risk of getting injured earlier in the night. As Mercy, with that swinging sidewalk slam, is she going to move on? No, only two.
And that was a really deep cover. So again, credit the fighting attitude of Erica Torres, the former champion, for kicking out of that. That was a deep cover by Mercy.
And Mercy again trying to stay on Torres, going right after. Look, Morgan Mercy, she's always been powerful. She's always been big, bad, and mean. But in my opinion, Morgan Mercy has come a long way inside that ring since she first came to MPX a couple of years ago. Staying on top of her opponent like we're seeing here tonight with Torres. Not letting Torres get any rest, any recuperation. But Torres still fighting back from the corner. And now hooking Mercy's head. And that kick to the head, nowhere for Mercy to go. And Torres charging in. Shotgun drop kick. Is Mercy going to face Hilda next week for the title? Two. No. Excuse me, Torres, but Mercy getting that right shoulder up.
You mentioned how far Mercy's come. If you look at Morgan Mercy's social media, you can see that she's gone a lot of different places and wrestled in a lot of different areas. But there's no substitute for experience but experience. And Torres has years of experience on Mercy.
And now Torres with several right hands. But again, a lot has been taken out of her in this match. And that bicycle kick from Mercy.
Might be a little too close to the ropes, though. Still a kick out.
And that could just be Erica Torres not realizing where she's at in the ring, not realizing she's close to the ropes. As Mercy questioning referee Travis Trueborn's count. And this is where Mercy sometimes has faults, where she gets too upset, too frustrated. She needs to maintain focus if she wants any shot of leaving here with a title match next week.
We saw Erica Torres get frustrated after a pinfall earlier, but she didn't scream, she didn't yell. She got a little sigh, a little exasperation, but she didn't scream like Mercy just did.
Oh, and Torres!
Unbelievable.
Again, the power! Cover! Two! And again, Mercy staying in it. Just when you think Erica Torres is going to get the victory, Morgan Mercy kicks out at the last second.
No, and see, again, there was frustration there in Torres's face, but now she's gearing herself up to put it away.
And Torres gets whipped in, runs right into that big boot of Mercy again.
So many hits to the head of Torres.
But Torres not giving up.
Erica Torres is a lot of things. She's not a clean fighter. She does bend the rules a little bit, but there is no denying that she is a fighter with an indomitable spirit.
And Mercy taking too much time.
This is uncharacteristic.
Look, and Torres just shoved Trueborn into the ropes.
Told you, not afraid to bend the rules, but Mercy went a completely unplanned route. There's no way she should have done that.
We saw this earlier with Carmichael. I didn't think she could get Mercy up for this. Torture rack neck breaker.
Unbelievable.
And Torres with the cover. And Erica Torres gets another title match next week.
Here is your winner and the number one contender to the MPX Women's Championship, Erica Torres.
And Erica Torres next week looks to reclaim what she feels like is rightfully hers. And that's the MPX Women's Championship.
This is going to be another chapter in this storied rivalry. And I, for one, Cody Cox, I can't wait to be ringside for it.
That will be next week again here on a Thursday night. We hope you will be with us. But Matt Andrews up next. It is main event time. The MPX Champion, this Johnny Truth, Demo Diamond with Jamie Aller by his side, will be defending the MPX title against a former champion, the final boss, Exodus Prime. That is our main event. It is up next, MPX's Shock and Awesome. We heard from the MPX champion, Demo Diamond's manager, Jamie Aller, earlier tonight. Jamie Aller claimed that there is no connection between him and the Shiesty Mob. Very upset at our ringside photographer, Brian Pulver. All Pulver did was take a picture. That's what he's here to do. And that picture caught Jamie looking on. He claims he was looking at the addicts. I find that hard to believe.
The following is your main event. It is number one fall with a 30-minute time limit. And it is for the MPX Championship. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Jamie Aller. From the Emerald City, he is the MPX Champion. The Shining True.
A very confident Demo Diamond coming in here tonight to face Exodus Prime. Jamie Aller yelling at more addicts as he was doing earlier. And here comes the challenger, a man who would love to hold the MPX title once again. But he knows what the deal is. He saw what happened last week with Tatum Manning. I'm sure he saw what happened earlier tonight with Tatum Manning. Exodus Prime is gonna need eyes in the back of his head to make sure this is a fair one-on-one match with Demo Diamond here tonight.
I'm a hot shot, chemistry and crock pot. Doing work in crops, making moves in my crops top. With my bottom line, big new me, get your head pop. I'm the dreadnought, head huncho, this a head
pop. I'm into the next the challenger from Oak Cliff, Texas. He is the one, true,
Shiesty Mob that were out here earlier attacking Exodus Prime. How much of this crap do we gotta put up with? Where is MPX management at?
Why? Look, if Jamie's truly not affiliated with this, why isn't he jumping in to stop this?
Well, I wouldn't expect Jamie Aller to jump in and help anybody.
Well, he's not exactly doing anything to dissuade any of the rumors.
Where's the other officials? Where's security?
Well, Carl Knight is obviously out here.
Okay, but we've seen enough beatings. Look, Prime fighting back.
Well, of course he is.
And Exodus Prime, a 4-on-1 situation. And we don't have many people in the back that can even come out here and help Exodus. We saw it happen to Manning, Green.
Green and Cavins just got taken out. Oh.
And there's no way Exodus Prime can compete here. Oh, and now, hold on.
Now that.
The referee. And
hey, look. And Cedric's
we can't even have a match.
Adam look, Green back out again.
Green and Cavins again. As if they didn't get enough earlier.
Oh, my God. Tatum
and here
Manning
comes
is
Tatum
alive.
Manning. Tatum Manning out here now.
He's got his fist wrapped up in something.
And all hell is breaking loose. And look, I'm a company guy.
Trueborn's here.
I love MPX, but in my opinion, this is on whoever decided to make this deal with Shiesty Mob. This is on MPX here. I'm probably going to get in trouble for saying that. I don't care at this point. Why these guys would continue to be allowed in the building week after week after the decimation of the MPX roster. And if they get, I'm sorry, Matt, if they get anywhere close over here, it's every man for himself. I'm hitting the hay.
That's fine. I can handle myself.
Getting the hell out of here.
It looks like Green and Cavins and Manning have taken the Shicey Mob out of the equation here. But how much of a match are we going to be able to
well,
have
we
here?
Don't have a referee.
I thought Trueborn was sticking around. There's no way.
Cedric Scott is down. Dylan Diamond. Oh!
Mass Exodus!
Mass Exodus!
But there's no bell. There's no ref.
The match hasn't even officially begun yet.
But you got to believe it has, that Exodus would have gotten another MPX championship reign.
And despite everything, Exodus Prime with that Mass Exodus could have won the title there. And referee Cedric Scott being woken back up.
He doesn't even have his glasses on.
And we have not. And the referee, he's got to call for a bell here. Spear! Spear! And the match starts! Now the match starts! Two!
Okay. Unbelievable! Exodus Prime just kicked out of that spear from Demo Diamond.
Demo Diamond thought that was it. He thought it was going to be an easy night for him.
I mean, so did I. So is this match actually still happening
well,
now?
Well, it
then?
Is. Okay. I mean, yes, Senator Scott called for the bell as he tries to shake off the cobwebs.
But even despite that Mass Exodus, there's no way that this is any kind of even playing field right now between these two men.
Prime fighting back.
I can't believe Exodus is fighting back after the beating that he took from that shiesty ball.
Oh, what a clothesline. You know, and I speculated earlier if we were going to see them, they didn't even wait till the match begun. I at least thought if we saw them, it would be towards, you know, in the middle of the match at least.
There's no rules for those guys. There's no rules. We saw it earlier with the beatdown that they had of Manning, Cavins, and Green. Cody, let's try to regroup here. There are rules in this match, and Demo Diamond almost getting himself
And I would be more apt to believe that there was no connection between Jamie Oller and the Shiesty Mob if they had attacked Demo Diamond as well.
Oh, yeah. They acted like he wasn't even in the ring. And for people that want opportunity, if you're not going to attack the champ, what kind of opportunity are you looking for?
I think that's an excellent point. Lateral press from Diamond. Only a two count.
I would have a lot more respect for the Shiesty Mob if they went after the champ. That's the top prize in this business.
Respect got thrown out the window weeks ago when Shiesty Mob first entered. There's no respect on their part. And we don't respect them. And I say we, I mean MPX is a company, but I'm talking about Tatum Manning, Adam Green, Dylan Cavins. I have respect for those guys who, despite the odds, come out here and try to take it to the Shiesty Mob. Another Mass Exodus. No, he gets thrown off.
Going for another spear.
Two. And only a two count is now. Demo Diamond, a nice counter for Prime. Shoulders are down, and Jamie Oliver's over. He's not even paying attention. He's trying to intimidate a little girl. His guy almost lost the title. And Demo Diamond, huge Uranagi. Another cover.
I'm not going to lie, it looked like Exodus landed hard on that arm.
Because now Jamie Oller looking on.
You think he's aware of just how close Demo was
no.
to losing that?
But in his mind, he's got all the confidence in the world. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with having confidence in a guy like Demo Diamond. But Exodus Prime on his feet fighting back. Oh, but Diamond with that forearm shot. Dropping Exodus.
Let's not forget how Exodus got here, winning a four-way elimination match last week at Summer Challenge. So it's not like Exodus isn't used to having the odds stacked against him.
Oh, another counter! Prime with the stunner! And Diamond somehow still on his feet.
Not sure he knows where he is, though.
And now Prime trying to get Diamond up, but Demo with those elbow shots.
Exodus has taken a lot of damage. Don't forget, not just from Demo Diamond, but from the Shiesty Mob that was here earlier.
Oh, Inzaguri, you heard the sound of that reverberate throughout the building. And now Prime from the middle rope, that leaping European uppercut. and Jamie All are over there showing Diamond the title, reminding him what it's all about here tonight.
Diamond is going to need a lot of that expertise from Jamie Aller. Jamie Aller has guided many a champion to victory in MPX. Exodus has been a champion in MPX. Demo's going to need a lot of Aller's experience and expertise to guide himself past Exodus.
And Prime trying to get a full Nelson locked, but I think Diamond just a little bit too tall for Exodus Prime to get those fingers locked in. German suplex and Prime holds on. Exodus Prime rolling through with that German as Demo trying to grab at one of the ropes. Another German.
Really great way to snap those hips. He's really getting Diamond over.
But Exodus Prime giving every last bit of effort he has inside of him to dish out these German suplexes, looking for a third. Diamond not allowing it to happen. Missed with the back elbow. Connects with the knee. Oh, but now Prime. Olympic slam. Olympic slam on Demo.
Exodus just getting to the cover, though.
And the lateral press, only a two count.
You saw the way that Exodus grabbed the back of his neck. He's doing it again. He grabbed it on the after that Olympic slam. And that delayed the cover by just enough to allow the champion to kick out.
And now Exodus, he might be looking for the contra code. Little counter, backdrop. Oh, shoulders are down on Demo.
Oh.
Huge right hand. Follows up with that roaring elbow. And now Diamond, instead of going for a cover, looking to show off the strength, the power, and that vertical suplex. Hooks the outside leg, two. And Prime somehow getting that right shoulder up.
Again, all of the impact driving down on the back of Exodus Prime's neck. You can see him grabbing that huge, huge move that is probably going to pay dividends for Diamond later on.
And Diamond yelling at some of the addicts, and I hear Jamie Aller telling Diamond to stay focused.
Well, he's one to talk. But that being said, Aller needs to be the one doing the yelling at the addicts.
Prime back on his feet. Gets into the outside. And now Diamond charging in. Prime with a forearm shot.
That's a forearm shot to rival Demo's own.
Oh, and Prime with a bit of a spear of his own from the apron. And Prime back on the apron. Oh, he was going to go over that springboard helo. He saw Diamond about to block it.
Scouting on scouting on scouting. These two men have studied each other so well.
And now Prime up and over. Face first goes Diamond.
Great inverted blockbuster.
Oh, and Diamond doing the smart move on the advice of Jamie Aller, rolling to the outside, not allowing the challenger to get the pin.
We just talked about that. Aller guiding his champion to a point where he wasn't going to get pinned.
Keep your eyes on the challenger. Tope Suicida sending Diamond right back into the guardrails.
Demo hit really hard into that guardrail.
And Prime's got to stay on him. Get him back in there. Oh.
To your point, Cody.
Yeah, Prime took his eye off the ball. And now face first.
Inverted fireman's carry slam. I'm not sure. Look, right now, this favors the champion, Demo Diamond. If there's a count out, Diamond retains his championship.
And Jamie helping Demo back to his feet.
Five! Let's go, X.
And Demo Diamond has no issues getting a count out victory here against Exodus Prime. A win is a win in the champion's book.
Right. Referee Cedric Scott telling Prime that he'll count him out, but I don't think Prime knows that Cedric just said that. He's still rolled in the ring just before the count of 10 anyway, and now Demo back on the attack.
And Diamond has to be looking to finish his opponent off here, but Prime still fighting back. Several open-handed shots.
Come on, man.
And Nexus making sure to keep his shoulders up. But Diamond turning over in a Boston Crab. I don't know that we normally see this from Demo Diamond. I cannot recall, Matt, Demo Diamond getting any sort of submission victory here at MPX.
No, it's not his game, but maybe that's part of the strategy to throw Prime off of his game, knowing that Demo can hit a submission at any point.
Oh, Demo shoulders down.
Really clever way to turn that into a pin, but Prime has got to be hurting. His spine, his neck, all of it being impacted by that Boston Crab.
Oh, right to the back. Oh, and Prime with that full Nelson backbreaker variation. Thought maybe he was going to look for that Snapdragon suplex he likes to use. As both men are down, opposite corners. Who's going to get to the feet first? Both men using the ropes to get back up. Prime up, Demo up. Oh, Demo got caught.
He was looking for that spear.
Double underhook, plants him face first. Variation of the Contra Code, but no. Diamond again trying to roll out of the ring. Prime not allowing it. And Jamie Aller just put the foot of the champion on the rope.
Look, Aller's presence is paying off right there. But I mean, Diamond knew where he was going in the first place. He had the presence of mind to roll towards the ropes. I'm not sure he needed Aller there, but he's got to be thankful that he was.
And now Exodus Prime, he's going hunting. He's hunting after Aller.
He's taking his eye off the ball.
Aller is on the run.
I've never seen a walrus move like that.
Oh, wait a second. Aller dropped the title in the lap of Demo. Demo has the title.
No.
The referee and Prime, they don't see it. And Prime turns around. Oh, he got hit right in the head. Exodus Prime.
Well, I don't know, Cedric. How do you think the belt got there?
Prime back up. Truth Seeker. And Demo Diamond retains.
Here is your winner.
Another successful title defense for the Shining Truth, Demo Diamond. You gotta give credit to Exodus Prime. Anyone else, after getting attacked by four men before the match even started, the Shiesty Mob.
I was gonna say, you wanna give credit to Exodus Prime, I give credit to the Shiesty Mob for taking him out beforehand.
But my point is, Exodus Prime, he could have said, hey, you know what, I can't go right now. And he most likely would have been given another shot in a couple of weeks. He said, the hell with it. I want Demo Diamond, I want him tonight. Maybe to his detriment. Nevertheless, Demo Diamond, still your MPX champion. Addicts, we appreciate you being with us here tonight. Make sure you're back here with us next Thursday for more action. We know MPX Women's title will be on the line. Hilda one-on-one with the former champion, Erica Torres. Until next week, for Matt Anders, I'm Cody Cox. We'll see you next week. Good night, everybody.